Hello students, in the first chapter, that is basic concepts of geometry, we have already completed 7 sums. This is the 8th sum. In the 8th question, we are asked to write the converse of the following statements. Okay, converse means ulta. We have already done it in the exercise as well. Okay, if the sum of the measure of angle in a figure is 180, then figure is a triangle. This is a given question. So the answer will be if the figure is a triangle, okay, if the is a triangle, then sum of the measure of angle is 180. Then sum of the measure of angles is 180. Okay, so whatever is at the end is written in the first. So if the figure is a triangle, then sum of the measure of angle is 180. Whatever was given, it's reverse. I wrote it, that is, reverse is known as converse. Okay, now the second one. If the measure of two angles is 90 degree, then they are complement of each other. See, first of all, what is complementary angles? If one angle is 40 and other angle, one angle is 50 and other angle is 40, and its sum is 90. One angle is 30 and other is 60, its sum is 90. One angle is 20, other is 70, its sum is 90. Okay? One angle is 10, other angle is 80, its sum is 90. If sum of any two angle is 90 degree, then this pair, or jodi we can say, okay, this pair is called as complementary pair or complementary angles. Okay, so it is given that the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degree and they are complement of each other. So we can say that if two angles are complementary angles, okay, if two angles are complementary angles, then their sum will be 90 degree. Okay, see, if sum is 90 degree, they are complement. If two angles are complementary angles, then their sum will be 90 degree. Okay, now the third one. If the corresponding angles formed by the transversal of the two lines are congruent, then the lines are parallel. See, what is given? First of all, I'll erase this first one. Okay, there are two lines. If corresponding angles, what is corresponding angle? When there is two lines, there is a transversal. Okay, the angle which is above the line is called corresponding angle. Below the line is called corresponding angle. Same this side also. Above the line, corresponding angle. Below the line, corresponding angle. Okay? So these are the pair of corresponding angles. And if the lines are parallel, then these pairs will be equal. Okay? See, if the lines are parallel, then this, they are already the pair of corresponding angle. But when they will be equal? If the lines are parallel. So let's see. If the corresponding angles formed by the transversal of two lines are congruent, then the lines are parallel. It is given that first, if the corresponding angle are equal, then the lines will be parallel. So we will write that if two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles formed by transversal of two lines are congruent. Okay, what was given? If the corresponding angle formed by the transversal of two lines are congruent, then the lines are parallel. We wrote it reverse. If the two lines are parallel, then this comma, okay, then corresponding angle formed by the transversal of two lines are congruent. Okay, I'll read it again. If two lines are parallel, then corresponding angle formed by the transversal of two lines are congruent. Okay, in the fourth one of the eighth part, it is given that if the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3. Suppose I have a number 72. Okay, so if the sum of the digit, that is 7 plus 2, it is 9. Okay, if the sum of the digit is 9 and if this number is divisible by 3, okay, if this number is divisible by 3, then the whole number is also divisible by 3. Okay, we know this. We have seen this in 5th standard. Okay, so we'll write the converse. If the number is divisible by 3, then the sum of its digit will also be divisible by 3. Okay, if the number is divisible by 3, we already know that if the number is divisible by 3, then the sum of the digits will also be divisible by 3. Okay, in the ninth question, write antecedent, that is given part, and the consequent, that is part, to be proved if the following statements are. Okay, see, if in the following statement, if we have if and then it is very easy. Then it is very easy to write antecedent and consequent. Okay, so first I write antecedent. Whatever is there after if, that is antecedent. And whatever is after then, it is consequent. Okay. If all the sides of the triangle are congruent, if all the sides of triangle are congruent, okay, then part to be proved is All the angles are congruent. When you will go further in geometry, you will have such sums. Then something is given and something is to be proved. Okay. Now the second. Diagonals of the parallelogram bisect each other. Now we don't have this if and then. So we need to identify it. Okay, diagonals of the parallelogram, therefore quadrilateral is a parallelogram, if quadrilateral is a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, therefore we need to prove that diagonals bisect each other. Okay, so this is antecedent and this is consequent. This is given. Quadrilateral is a parallelogram. We need to prove that diagonals bisect each other. Okay, in the 10th question, you can see that draw a labeled figure showing information in each of the following statement and with the antecedent and the consequent. Okay, so we need to write the diagram. And we need to write given part and part to be proved. Okay. So two equilateral triangles. So I draw two triangles. ABC. I'll name this PQR. Okay. Two triangles are equilateral triangles. So what will be the given part, or we can say the antecedent part? Will be ट्रायंगल एबीसी एंड ट्रायंगल पीक्यूआर आर इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल. ओके एंड द कॉन्सिक्वेंट पार्ट विल बी इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल आर सिमिलर मीन्स ट्रायंगल एबीसी is similar to triangle PQR. So this is the sign of a similar. Okay, I feel that this is the answer which is to be given, that we need to draw two triangles which are equilateral triangle, and this is the given part and this is the consequent part. If in the school you have a varying answer, if you have a different answer, do let me know. Okay, it's not an issue. Okay, in the second one, if angles in linear pair are congruent. Okay, so I'll draw linear pair angle. I'll name it as A. Label is important. Is okay? B, C. We have a ray. D. Okay. What is given for antecedent part? If the angles in linear pair are congruent, okay. These angles are congruent. This angle is equal to this angle. So I'll write DBA is equal to DBC. Okay, this is congruent, and we need to prove that. We need to prove that both the angles are 90 degree, that is DBA is equal to DBC is equal to, yes, we can also prove it, but I think this much only is asked as per the question. Okay, again I am telling you, if there is any extra answer, do let me know in the school, we will just correct it. Okay, now the last question of the first lesson. If the altitude drawn on the two sides of the triangle, okay, so first we'll draw a triangle. A, B, C, okay. Altitude drawn on the two sides of a triangle. So I'll draw one altitude from here. Altitude is 90 degree. Okay. And for your better understanding, I'll use this pen. So what is given? If the altitude drawn on the two sides of the triangle are congruent, means this altitude is congruent. So given part will be BT is congruent to BT is congruent to CS. Okay, this is congruent. Then those two sides means what? On which the altitude is drawn, that is AC is congruent to AB. Okay, if altitude drawn on the two sides are congruent, if these altitudes are equal, then where they are drawn, then those two sides are also congruent. Okay, so this is the end of the 10th chapter of basic concepts of geometry. Okay, try to solve the lesson once again. Okay.